Hey guys, what's up? Today I'm going to be unboxing two packages from thecubicle.com. In these packages there are three cubes, the new Dian Tengyum M3x3, the Moyu Alfu GTS M7x7, and the X-Man Spark M7x7. So first, let's take a look at the Moyu Alfu GTS M. This cube has a pretty nice magnetic box with a few cards inside, but let's just get straight onto the cube. Just holding it in my hands, it seems to feel a little bit larger than most 7x7s. I'm not actually sure what the dimensions are in comparison to most 7x7s, but I would expect that this cube would be at least 1 or 2 millimeters larger. Doing first turns, I can definitely tell that this is a new and improved version of the Alfu because it has the same soft, smooth, and slightly sluggish feeling that the Alfu originally had. The tensions also feel very tight out of the box, and so right now, the turning isn't very fluid. However, in my experience, 7x7s take a while to reach their full potential, so I'll definitely have to do a lot of solves on this cube before I can really decide my opinion on it. For now though, I'm probably going to need to loosen it up a bit and possibly add some DNM37 to speed it up. Hopefully that won't cause any popping problems, but if it does, then I'll adjust from there. The next cube in the box is another new 7x7, the X-Man Spark M. This cube feels a bit smaller than the Alfu GTS M, which I personally like. Doing first turns, this cube impressed me right away. It's fast, decently fluid, and fairly smooth. It already feels like it could give my Haze 7M a run for its money, and I've broken that cube in for a while now. Of course, this cube is on much looser tensions than the Alfu GTS M out of the box, so I'm sure that has something to do with the increased fluidity and speed of the Spark M right away. Unfortunately, the Spark does feel a little bit less stable than the Alfu GTS, and I could see there being a potential problem with popping and solves, so I'll have to see if that does become a major problem with this cube. Anyway, I will do a bit of work with these cubes over the next week or two, and hopefully I'll have a comparison between these two 7x7s and the Haze 7M out soon. Finally, we have Dian's new 3x3, the Tengyun M. The first thing I noticed when I took this cube out of the box is that the stickerless shades on this cube are a bit brighter than the dull stickerless shades that Dian had on some of their past cubes, which is definitely a change for the better. Doing first turns, this cube has a unique dry feeling which I enjoy quite a bit. The pieces seem to really glide over each other and there's hardly any resistance at all. Of course, this means that overshooting can become a big problem, and so I expect that I'll need to add some lube into this cube to bring it under control. Apart from that, this cube has some of the best corner cutting I've ever seen, on par with that of the GAN356X, which I was a bit surprised to see. However, the performance in solves isn't anything special, at least not yet, and so I definitely need to mess around with this cube a bit to see if I can make it work for me. So that's it for this short unboxing of these three cubes. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!